Today we have an interactive session with Mr. Shubham Singh of IIT Gandhinagar. As a part of our online problem solving sessions, we had 9 sessions so far. Today we have a session on integral calculus. I would like to thank Mr. Shubham Singh for accepting our invitation to join with us.
So, can I start with the presentation now? So, good afternoon to everyone. This is Shubham Singh, and today we are going to talk about the integration and its applications. So, as you know, students, JAM has a very big part of this topic. Every year some questions comes from these some topics of integration and its applications. So today's session is all about this. So we are starting with some contents what we are going to study in today's session. So firstly, a brief introduction about integration, and then what are types of integrals. Then we will talk about areas of bounded regions. In various regions, if some curves are given us to us, so we will talk about the areas of that bounded regions. Then we will talk about arc length of a plane curve, then volume of solids. After that, we will come to the surface area of a solid of revolution. So in the last, I have mentioned a reference book for all of you. If you would like to study and go through that, that's very interesting book. So starting with the introduction, so as all of you know a little bit about the integration, so what is an integral, we will talk here. So if we consider fx a function which is continuous on a closed interval ab, so then we can take a function capital fx which is equals to fx, that is the derivative of that capital x function f is equals to small f. So that capital f function is known as the antiderivative of fx. This I think all of you know. So this is the basic definition of antiderivative. So if fx capital fx is an antiderivative of small f of x, then fx plus c, that is with some constant c. So this is also an antiderivative of small f of x. So now we will come to the parts of what are the types of integrals we have. First one is indefinite integral. So if we consider fx capital fx is an antiderivative of small f of x on closed interval ab, then for any arbitrary constant c, this capital f of x plus c is called the indefinite integral of f of x on closed interval ab, and it is written like this. So these are the preliminary definitions for all of you. So in this case, we say that the function f is f of x, small f of x, is integrable on closed interval ab. Such type of functions are called as integrable on closed interval ab. So we note that every function is not integrable. For example, the function defined here is 0 when x belongs to rational numbers and 1 when x belongs to irrational numbers, that is on closed interval 0 1. So this function does not have an antiderivative. So from here we can conclude that for integration we need that function should have an antiderivative, and then we can say then we can talk about its integrability. So this function here is not integrable. So from here a theorem comes out that every function which is continuous on a closed and bounded interval is integrable. So this is very important theorem for integrability. So now second type of integral is definite integral. So if we consider small f of x a continuous function on the closed interval ab, then the definite integral of fx over the interval closed interval ab is written as this. So here we are defining some limits for that integration. So here we don't use that arbitrary constant. So this is simply written as this. So these are the types of integrals. Now we come to the main part of our today's session, that is areas of bounded regions. So I'm not going into the deep theory. So just I would tell you a basic results, and on the basis of those results, we will do some exercises, problems. So these are more helpful for you, because for the JAM, they will definitely ask you problems. Not they don't ask more questions from the theoretical part of this topic. So if we consider the areas for the first type, that is the area of the region bounded by the curve of type y is equal to f of x. Like the curve is given as y is equal to f of x, and this region is bounded by these curve y equal to f of x, the x-axis and the lines x is equal to a and x is equal to b. So in the figure below, you can see the region which is given, and we have to find the area of this bounded region. So how can we find the area? This is simply calculated as integral from a to b, that is given as the limits of x from a to b, y of dx. Y is given to us, that is curve which is given, and it is, should be integrated from a to b. So this is the integral for this is the area for the curve of these type of curves if we are given with. So here how you will decide like limits? So you have to take a horizontal strip you can take in the like in the bounded region. So there you can decide about the limits, like what are the limits if they are not giving you the limits of x from a to b. So you can take these limits from the horizontal strip in that bounded region and take limits from there. Now we come to the second type, that is second type of the curves, the area of the region bounded by the curve x is equal to phi of y. Like earlier we had y equal to f of x, now we have x is equal to phi of y, and now this is again bounded by y axis and the lines y equal to c and y equal to d. Here we take the boundary region on the y axis. So here you can see that similar process but different, like a small change is there. Okay, so there you had y of dx, here you have x of dy. So you can simply put those values here and evaluate this integral, and you will get the area of the curve x is equal to phi of y, which is and the y axis, which is bounded by y axis. So here this is the second type, same little difference between both the areas, small. So now comes to the third part. If the two curves are given to you, like enclosed, and the area is enclosed between two those two curves, y equal to fx and y equal to gx, and the limit is given for the x, that is x is equal to a and x is equal to b is given by. So here area you can calculate by the difference of fx and gx. Why the difference is taken to be fx minus gx? Because we consider here that fx is greater than equal to gx in that closed interval, that fx is a greater function than the gx in that particular closed interval. So we consider the area as integral from a to b, f of x minus gx dx. So this is the third type of type to calculate the area of bounded regions. Now we come to the fourth type. If the interval which is given to us, that is closed interval a b, and it is further divided into two sub intervals, that is closed interval a to c and closed interval c to b, and the behavior of the both the functions is different. Like in the closed interval a c, if the function fx is greater than equal to gx, and in the interval closed interval c to b, the function fx is smaller than function gx, then we write the area as this, that expression you are seeing on your screen. So here, this is area is equal to integral from a to c f of x minus gx dx plus integral c to b gx minus fx dx. So from figure you can see that the curve is a curve of function fx is upper than gx, and the in the interval a to c and in the interval c to b the curve of function gx is upper to the function f of x. So this you can visualize from the picture if you draw for that functions. So basically the idea to calculate the areas, we have to firstly we have to draw the regions. So that will help us a lot, because from the region we can decide of that function we have to take integration, limits of the integral. So these all things we can decide from the figure. So firstly you should try to draw the figure, and then that is very much easy after that to evaluate the area. Now we come to the fifth after that, this is the area of bounded by a curve represented in parametric form. Earlier we had simple curves in x or y form, you have seen, but now if the curve is given in parametric form, that is if the x function is in some t type and y is also in some t form, these type of parametric forms you have seen and heard it earlier. So how to find the area of such type of curves? So here let the curve y equal to f of x be defined in parametric form as x is equal to phi of t, y is equal to psi of t, where t lies between a and b, that is t belongs to closed interval a and b, where phi and psi are continuous functions of t in the interval a b. So here x node, that is the value of phi of a, because earlier the curve y is defined for where x belongs to closed interval a b. So here we will evaluate x node, that is the limit for the parametric form. So here x node is equal to phi of a and x1 is equal to phi of b. So from here you will get the values of x node and x1. Then from c1, that is from earlier area we have calculated for the bounded regions, the area is given as, that is area is equal to integral x0 to x1 y of dx, and here x0 we have taken as phi of a, or we can take that a, and x1 is b. Then how to define y? Here is psi of t, and dx, what is dx? This is phi dash of t into dt, that is dx. So we can write this area in parametric form like this. So many of times they give you the curve in parametric form and then they will ask you to evaluate the area. So you can evaluate the area in this type of integral. A tough task to do. So simply evaluate the limits, change the limits in the form of t, and then just put the values of y and dx, you can get the area. Now we will talk about the area of a sector. Like sector is what? Sector is some part of a circle. It is some part of a circle. So if we want to evaluate the area of that sector, so how can we do that? So firstly we have to define the curve in a polar form. So curve is defined as r is equal to f of theta, and where theta belongs to some alpha closed interval alpha beta. So an f of theta is the continuous function is in closed interval alpha to beta. Then the area of the sector bounded by the curve, that curve r is equal to f of theta, and the radial lines. Radial lines means that is the lines theta is equal to alpha and theta is equal to beta. These are the radial lines. So these lines, area bounded by these this function, continuous function f of theta and the radial lines, is given as half of integral a to alpha to beta r square of d theta. So here you will find that r is given to you, just square it and multiply it with d theta. So and alpha beta you are given with, so you can easily compute this area. So this is the area of a sector. Now we come to the examples part of this section of the area of bounded regions. These all the regions were bounded, so how to compute the areas. So consider the first example. So in this example what we are given, that find the area of the region enclosed between the curves y equal to root of x and y is equal to x of square. What are the curves we are given with? Y is equal to root of x and y is equal to x square. These two curves are given to us. So we have to find the limits. So what are the limits of x? We know, so we can evaluate the area from the C1 type of talked about the type of area, how to evaluate in the area of bounded regions. That was the first quotation. That so in that we have to find the intersection of these two curves. Where do they intersect? So these curves gets intersect at 0 and 1. So these are the two points where these two curves intersect. Now we know that the examiner is asking about the area bounded between 0 and 1. So we know that in this closed interval, root x is greater than equal to x square always. So we can evaluate the area as integral from 0 to 1 root of x minus x square dx. So this is simply, you can calculate that is 1 by 3 of square units. So now is given in the same, we were talking about the parametric form. So this type of question you will be given parametric form. So find the area of the region enclosed by the curve x is equal to a of t minus sin t and y is equal to a of 1 minus cos t. So these are the curves you have given with. So here t lies between 0 and 2 pi. So we know that as t varies from 0 to 2 pi, then what is the value of x? X varies from 0 to 2 pi a. Why? Because when we put t to 0, we get x as 0. And when we put t as 2 pi, then we get x as 2 pi a. So what is the area? Area is, we know that that is the limit of t is limit of that x is from 0 to 2 pi a. And what is the that integral inside that? That is, we talked about that here. That is psi of t y times dx. That is here psi of t times phi dash of t. So here we will do that same thing. A of 1 minus cos t, that is y. And then we will talk about the d of x, that is, phi dash of t. So here it is a of 1 minus cos t. So this integral you can evaluate easily. So that integral gives you the area, that is 3 pi a cube. So simply this is not that much tough. Just you have to use your basic knowledge, that what is the formula and then what you are given with, and just put the all those values in the formula. That is simple. Just simply what one thing you have to find is that limits. These are the some difficult things many a times that we have to find. Otherwise all those other things are very simple. So now we come to the third question, that is asking about the area of a sector. So how can we evaluate? That is, find the area of the region that lies inside the circle r is equal to a cos theta and the outside the cardioid, that is given in this picture. That is r, that circle is drawn here and cardioid is also drawn. So what they are asking, area lies inside the circle and outside the cardioid, that is outside the cardioid. So we will not include that part which is common in circle and cardioid. So we are leaving that part. So here, the both these curves intersect at what? Theta is equal to plus minus pi by 3. These intersect at plus minus pi by 3. So if we take r1 as a cos theta and r2 as a of 1 minus cos theta, then the required area is given by that. And this area is given by the sector formula, that is the area of sector. So what was that formula? Half of that integral inside that is r square d theta. So what is here r square? So this is the two curves. So we will subtract them. So r1 square minus r2 square d theta. And what is the limit? That is from minus pi by 3 to plus pi by 3. So that this is a simple calculation. You can see here that is r1 square is equal to cos square theta, and we have taken that a square common from both the terms, and then we have simplified it and then simply calculate the area. So this one is the also is not a tough example. Now this is the example from previous year of JAM question papers. So what he was asking here, this was a little trickier example than previous ones. So what he's asking about the area bounded by the curves x square plus y square is equal to 2 of x, and x square plus y square is equal to 4 of x, and the straight lines y equal to x and y equal to 0. So I have not drawn the reason here. So, but I can tell you that first one is a circle centered at 1 with radius 1, and the second is the circle with radius 2 centered at 2. So the smaller circle is contained in the bigger circle, and we know that how to draw the y equal to x line and y equal to 0. So from here, we have to find the area bounded by all these four curves. So what was the area bounded by the curves is given as 1 by 4th area of circle with radius 2. So when you will draw the reason of that reason, then you will came to know about that there is a 1 by 4th part of a circle is given of that bigger circle with radius 2. So the area of that circle is 1 by that is pi r square. R is 2, so that is pi into 4. So 1 by 4th we have taken because that is only the 1 by 4th part of that complete circle. Now the area of that if we will take from the horizontal strip, like we will take, then we will come to know about the area some other because that is not the complete area that we have calculated, area of a circle with radius 2, that is not complete, but we have to add some other area which is given as given by this double integral. So I think you know how to solve these double integrals. So here, don't confuse with this. This is the limit of y, that is under root 1 minus x minus 1 ka, whole square from this to x. And the limit of x is from 1 to 2. Actually, there is I should have drawn that a reason. Then you will know that is better for you. So sorry for that. So here you can see easily that after that evaluating this integral, you will came to know about the answer. So that is not a tough calculation here. Just take x minus 1 as a t and then use that formula a square minus t square under root a square minus t square dt. That is the formula for integration. So you can use that simply. So this was the example of previous year JAM papers. So here answer is B. Now we come to the other part of our session, that is arc length of a plane curve. So we are talking about the plane curve. If some curve is given, plane curve is given, then how to calculate the arc length? of that plane curve. So consider a portion of the curve y equal to f of x. What we have to consider? A portion of the curve between some boundaries, that is x is equal to a and x is equal to b. Between some boundary, we have to consider a portion of the curve. And then the what is the length of that arc of the curve between that two points? What is that between that boundary is given by this formula. What is that formula? That is from integral a to b, that is the boundary, and root 1 plus dy by dx whole square and complete dx. So here how you will calculate dy by dx? So you will be given like x curve is given and y you will be given. So just use the chain rule, that is firstly evaluate dx with like dx by dt and then dy by dt, and then just do the simple calculation. Or you simply, if you are given with y equal to f of x, then you can simply find the this derivative dy by dx. So simply you can use this. So if the curve is defined in another form, that is x is equal to phi of y, where y lies between c and d, then the length of the arc is given by this formula. Here a small change is there. In place of dy by dx, it is given that dx by dy, and on the place of dx, it is given dy. So these are not the tough ones. So in this, we are again extending this arc length to a parametric form. So here also, that I was talking about, if x is given in the form of t and then y is given in the form of t, so where t lies between t naught and t1. So here you can simply evaluate dx by dt and then dy by dt and use the previous formula. That is, here you can use the chain rule, that is dy by dx is equal to dy by dt upon dx by dt. That is the chain rule. So you can use that and evaluate this value of dy by dx and use the previous formula. So that is not a tough one. So mainly in every reason you will find a parametric form, like in previous area of boundary reason we had parametric form. In this arc length, we have again have a parametric form. So simply, this is the like trickier part to evaluate. So they give more questions from this part also. So you can evaluate this one easily. Now, again here, we are going to talk about the polar form, arc length of a curve represented in polar form. So consider the portion of the curve defined by that curve r is equal to f of theta, where theta lies between alpha and beta, and f theta is a continuously differentiable on closed interval. So the curve can be represented in parametric form as, so here the form of the curve will be given like this: x is equal to r cos theta, where r is equal to f of theta. So x is equal to f of theta cos theta, and y is equal to r sin theta. This is the polar form, as you know. For x we use r cos theta, and for y we use r sin theta in the polar form. So here r is given as f of theta. So just use that value of r here, and we will get our values of x and y. Now simply derivative of x that is with respect to theta, that is dx by d theta is equal to f dash theta cos theta minus f of theta sin theta. So, and similarly you can find the derivative of y with respect to theta. And then we have to use this equation, that is dx by d theta whole square plus dy by d theta whole square, that is equals to f dash theta whole square plus f square theta. So this is the equation we have to use for the arc length of curve which is represented in polar form. So we will use this thing. So this is the formula, which is as s is equal to alpha integral from alpha to beta under root f dash theta whole square plus f square theta d theta. So here we know that f dash theta is equal to f square theta is equal to r square, and f dash theta whole square we can compute that. So that is dr by d theta whole square. So simply we can change that above form into this form, that is integral from alpha to beta and root r square d theta by dr whole square plus 1 into dr. So this is the arc length of a curve which is represented in polar form. So without going into much theory, these are the simple formulas which we can directly use and evaluate the answers. So for here, we don't want to just like earlier we were drawing some reasons. Here you can simply evaluate these questions. Like for example, here, find the total length of the curve. R, that curve is given as R is equal to a sine cube theta by 3. So here theta is also defined between 0 to 3 pi. So we have f theta is given to us, that is a sine cube theta by 3, and we can evaluate the f dash theta, then use that previous formula and put the values of all those terms which are required in the formula. So simply after simplifying, we will get s is equal to a, take a outside, and integral is from 0 to 3 pi sine square theta by 3 d theta. So simply take theta by 3 as phi, yes, theta by 3 as phi, and then change the limits from limits to phi that are from earlier theta was from 0 to 3 pi. When we take theta is equal to 0, then phi is the limit of phi is from 0 to pi. So you can change this limit. So here, after putting all those values of limits and changing that variables, we get this integral as simplified this, and we can evaluate the arc length here, so which is given as 3a pi by 2. So this is also not a typical one. So sometimes examples are given more typical, so but don't get panic and just use the sense and that what is given, we are given with, and just simply do the calculations required to you. So now we come to the volume of solids part, which is a very important topic. Earlier we are given on the topics which we were talking are slight easier than this one, because in this we get some confusion. So here we are talking about the first method, which is a method of slicing. So why we are talking about the slicing, saying that this method is method of slicing, which can be cleared from this diagram. I haven't written a complete theory of this method, but I would like to explain it to you, that these some planes are given to us on the axis. We are given we are given with the some planes. So if we slice them, so how to evaluate that volume after slicing these planes? So that we have to evaluate. So that converts into area, that volume converts into some area type of things that is given in these formulas. So for first type, we consider that a solid be bounded by two parallel lines. Like in this diagram, if we take two parallel planes, if we take and solid is bounded by both these planes. Planes, what are planes? These are x is equal to a and x is equal to b. Then what is the volume of that solid and how it is calculated? So we will just calculate the area, that is cross-sectional area. Here that this area is not the same as we were computing earlier, but this is a different one, that is the cross-sectional area. So you can evaluate this. So here is given by cross-sectional, AX is a cross-sectional area, and how to calculate volume, that is V is equal to integral A to B AX DX. And similarly, if the curve is bounded by the parallel planes, which are y is equal to c and d, then again you can calculate the volume of solid. And here the cross-sectional area is for y axis. So simply, these are not the tough ones again. So simply you have to, here you can just draw the figure if you are given. So just draw that planes and then try to figure out the cross-sectional area, and then you will see how to evaluate the volume of that solid. So here, now we come to the volume of a solid of revolution. Like if we are given a solid and then we revolve it about some given curves, then what volume we are getting about after revolution, that is after rotating that curve about some axis, like in the first part we are going to talk about this curve. So here, like let AB be the portion of a curve, y is equal to f of x. So this is some curve we are given here. So just take the portion AB of this curve, and the line y is equal to p. Y is equal to p line, take, and the line x is equal to a and x is equal to b is revolved about the line y is equal to p, which is a line parallel to the axis. That y is equal to p line is a line which is parallel to the x-axis, and we are given with two lines, x is equal to a and x is equal to b, which we are seeing here, that is from a c and b d. These are line. So when we will revolve the solid, rotate, or we can say rotate the solid around that x-axis, then what kind of volume we have of that solid? So that solid is given as volume is given as integral from a to b pi times y square dx. So about this volume, there is a little theory behind it. So simply here, if you can see a rectangle, that is SPRQ. So from here you can see that volume. So how to compute that volume? That is with some area, that is area multiplied with some length. That is volume. Actually, what is a volume? Volume is a area multiplied by, that is height. So if we multiply area with height, then we get a volume. So simply here, here we are given this rectangle. So from here we can have a some result from where we can conclude about the volume of this curve. So without going much into the theory again, so we have this formula. If you would like to go into that, if you want to study about the theory, just try to read the content given in the book, which I have mentioned in the reference. So from there you will definitely get an idea that why we have written the formula of volume like this. So you will definitely get some idea from there. If you have some doubt, again you can call me. I will give you some contact number also. So for other curve, like if we have given with the curve that is x is equal to phi of y, and the curve is given about the y-axis, and the lines, it is bounded by y equal to c, two planes that are y equal to c and y equal to d, and revolved about the y-axis, that this curve is revolved about y-axis. So then volume is changed slightly, that is in the place of y we are having x, and in the place of dx we are having dy. So actually, what is dx and dy playing a role here? Actually, dx and dy is a small height. If you will find the theory in this book, which is mentioned in the reference, so you will know that what is dx and dy here. So this is the volume of a solid of revolution. So now we will come to the remarks part of this volume. So there is something more about this. Earlier we were talking about the volume of solid of revolution about a line, like we were talking about that solid is revolved about some axis and it is bounded by some planes. But now here we are talking that if the area bounded by the curve y equal to fx and one line is also given there, that here y is equal to p line is given here, and the lines axis x equal to a, x equal to by b is the curve is bounded by, area of the curve is bounded by these things, and the revolve, that curve is revolved about the line, that is line parallel to the x-axis. Here this line y equal to p is parallel to the x-axis. So there we were revolving about about the axis, but here this that means revolvement, revolution of that curve is about that line, not about the axis. Here is that curve is revolved about the line y equal to p. So then how to evaluate the volume of this kind of solid of revolution? So this volume is given again. So here we will just do one thing, that is there we had some pi times y square. Here we will do that y minus p, that is we will take, and for the curve of type y, x is equal to g of y, we will take x minus q. Simply just a little formulation is there between the both the two volumes, there is a small like formulation. So this is the volume of a curve revolved about a line. So in JAM I've seen questions from this part many a times. So this is an important topic from the volume of solid of revolution. So they ask you about the volume revolved about the line and they will try to confuse you. So here you will need some awareness that how to compute that volume, and how to just here you have to compute some limits also. So that is a tricky part here. So we will discuss about that limits in the example section. So how to compute those limits. So now we will move to the other part of the volume, that is volume of solid of revolution by the method of cylindrical shells. So here I have given two figures, region of revolution and cross section of solid of revolution. The first one is the region of revolution, like in which region we are revolving that solid, and the second is the cross sectional view of that solid of revolution. So how we compute the volume of a solid of revolution by this method, that is cylindrical shells. So suppose that a region in the xy plane bounded by the curve y equal to fx and the x-axis and the lines x equal to a, x equal to v is revolved about the y-axis, that this region, given region, is revolved about the y-axis. So how can we compute the volume with the method of cylindrical shells? So this is the formula for that, that is v is equal to integral from a to b 2 pi x and that f of x dx. So here a little change is there. So again, for the theory part you can go for that book. So here, and if the curve is given, that the given curve is revolved about the x-axis, then the volume of the solid of revolution is obtained as 2 pi y g of y dy, that is this integral again in as in the earlier cases we are just changing from x to y and y to x. These are the some formulations we have to do. So simply look at the question carefully and then you will have to decide that which formula you have to apply and what are the limits, and what he is asking, that examiner is asking, that he has given you that the solid is revolving about y-axis, x-axis. So just look into that and apply this formula. So here we are given that x is equal to gy is the equation of the bounding curve, that is here in the region given APQB. This is the region, and x is equal to g of y. This is the equation of bounding curve. So from this we can compute the volume of solid of revolution by cylindrical shells method. Now we come to the examples part of this topic of volumes, volume of solids. So the first example is the cross sections of a certain solid made by planes perpendicular to the x-axis are circles with the diameters extending from the curve y equal to 3 of x square to the curve y equal to 16 minus x square. That means we are given with the two curves, that is y equal to 3x square and y is equal to 16 minus x square. So what is what the examiner is asking? He is asking find the volume of the solid which lies between the points of intersection of these curves. That he is asking about the volume which lies between the intersecting points of these two curves. So how to compute the intersection? We can compute simply by equating these two curves, that is 3x square is equal to 16 minus x square, and we will find the intersection point is, that is x, the value of x is plus minus 2. So the intersection intersecting points are minus 2, 12, and minus 2 and 12. These are the points of intersection for these two curves. So now any point on the curve y equal to 16 minus x square is r. Here we are given that is on the curve that y equal to 16 minus x square is the above the curve which is given above. So and y equal to 3x square is the curve which is given below. So here the point on that curve is what? What is that point? That is x comma 16 minus x square. And any point on the curve s which is given below, the point is x comma 3x square. So what is the diameter of the circle rs? So now here we are having that circle rs. When we will look this diagram in three dimensional, or the like we will have some rotating type of diagram that you will give you a different look, then you will see that RS is a circle. So and what is the diameter of that circle? We can have that is 16 minus 4x square. How we have computed? That is from the points we have added, we have subtracted that the second y point of that second curve, that is S. So that is 16 minus 4 of x square. This is the diameter of that circle. Now what is the area of that circle? That is this is the 1 by 4th of that simply that is 1 by half we are taking here, because that is radius whole square and into that is half square is equal to 1 by 4. So we have the area of the circle as AX. That is the cross-sectional area we are coming into here. That part, that is the area of cross-section here that you are looking here. That area of cross-section is 4 pi times 4 minus x square whole square. So we are seeing here that this diagram, which is for which we have to evaluate the volume, this is symmetric about y-axis. This is symmetric about y-axis. So what we have to do? We have to evaluate the volumes two times. So simply do a multiplication by 2 to the volume. So what is the volume? 2 times integral from 0 to 2. That is the limit of x, we can say. So that is the limit of x, that is from 0 to 2. AX DX. So after that, this is the simple calculation and you can find the volume, which is 2048 by 15 cubic units. Now we come to the example number 7. What that says? That says find the volume of the solid generated by revolving the finite region bounded by the curves y equal to x square plus 1, y equal to 5 about the line x equal to 3. So this is the reason of this curve y equal to x square plus 1, y equal to 5 and the line x equal to 3. So this is the reason. So we have to find the volume of this region, solid generated by revolving the finite region. So the region bounded by these curves. So how to evaluate the volume? So volume, what we have given, we are giving with the second method, which was here. This method, we are volume of a solid of revolution. So these formulas we will use in that question, that is this. So the volume is given as pi integral from 1 to 5. So why we have chosen that limit to be 1 to 5? So y is from y equal to 5 is given here, and if we put x equal to 0, like in this diagram we can see that limit of x is equal to y is from 0 1 to 5. That is, when we put x equal to 0, then we get y equal to 1 and y is equal to 5. That is the limit of y. So the volume is given as x1 whole square minus x2 whole square. That is, what is x here? So from here we will say see that x is 3 plus under root 1 y minus 1. This is x. Here you will see that if we use x is 3 plus and one time this is 3 minus. That is, we have to take the values of x1 and x2 and just square them and take the difference of those two values, and we will get the volume of that that is x, volume of that region with this formulation. So simply after calculating this values, we will come to the value, that is under root y minus 1 in the integral part. So after that, there is a not that much tough calculation here. So here in this example, the computation of x is more important. As you can see that for here, we cannot talk about the symmetry or something else. So we are given something like that x1 and x2 type of points on that curve. In this diagram, we are seeing that. So we have to just find the value of x1 and x2. So what is x1 and x2? These are the main part of this example, which we have to find, and then after that the simple calculation is there. So from diagram you can look that x1 is slightly on the left hand side of y-axis, and x2 point is on the slightly on the right hand side of x-axis. That's why x2 is 3 minus under root y minus 1 and x1 is 3 plus under root y minus 1. So this is the simple volume that is we have to, because actually the line x equal to 3 is given there, na? So we have to subtract the right hand side of that bounded region from the given region. We have to subtract one this side, which is given from 0 x from 0 to x equal to 3. This some part of the we have to minus. So that's why we are doing x1 square minus x2 whole square. So this is some tricky example. So just be aware in such type of examples to take the values of x and or y, whatsoever you are to evaluate. So now we move to the example number 8. So here he is asking, find the volume of the solid generated by revolving the region bounded by the curves y equal to 3 minus x square and y equal to minus 1 about the line y equal to minus 1. So here, that is the most important part of the volume. He's asking about that volume of the solid after revolving about the line. So I have made a diagram here that is inverted parabola type of this, and the required region is given in this figure. So the region PAQ here, PAQ is revolved about the line y equal to minus 1. So this region is revolved about the line y equal to minus 1. So this region, again, we can say, see here that this is symmetrical about y-axis. This region is symmetrical. That is the area on the right hand side of y and the area on the left hand side of the y-axis, both are the same. So we have to evaluate both areas. So we are just multiplying the volume to evaluate volume. We are just multiplying it total volume by 2. So what is the volume of one part if we want to find? That is volume of the solid obtained by revolving the region PAR, that is one side of this region about the line y equal to minus 1. We are going to revolve the region PAR about the line y equal to minus 1, and then we find the volume of this region and then just multiply it by 2. So in that section we talk about the volume. What was the formula for that volume? The formula was volume is equal to pi times that limit of the integral and x minus p or y minus q time whole square d of x and some d of y. Here we are talking about that the curve is given as y equal to 3 minus x square. So we are taking that y minus that q form, and dx is after that. So here the volume is 1 plus y1 whole square dx. So just after that, this is the simple computation you can do. But the reason how you will decide here, again, you can say see here that x1, y1, the point is given on the region. So just you see here that this strip, which is made from x1, y1 to this vertical strip, this strip gives you a hint that after x-axis, this is one unit downwards x-axis on the y-axis side. So what you have done is y1 plus 1. So that's why, or simply you can just take minus 1 on this left-hand side, and you will see that y plus 1 is equal to 0. That is from that equation about of the line. So simply first thing is that you, if you are able to draw the diagram of that region, and then after that the evaluation of whether it is area, whether it is volume, whether it is volume of solid of revolution or about some line. So that is very easy after drawing a figure. So that is the importance of drawing a figure or some region about which you are to evaluate the volume or area. So this is the example for the important part of that volume section. Now we are talking about the parametric form. So here, find the volume of solid generated by revolving an arc of the cycloid x equal to a t minus sin t and y equal to a t minus cos t, and x is x-axis about the x-axis. So we have to find the volume of this solid. So setting y equal to 0 here, we obtain cos t is equal to 1. So here we are obtaining, when we put y equal to 0, we get cos t is equal to 1. How we will get that? That is y equal to 0, cos t is equal to, here cos t is equal to t we will get. So here there is one misprint, that is there is not 1, this is cos t is equal to t, or v is equal to, there is some mistake here. So we have to check, just a minute, I have to check it, this example in my book, whether this is written correctly or not. Wait a minute. Yeah, here there is one mistake. That is y, the curve is y equal to a 1 minus cos t. This is the curve. So simply this written, the cos t is equal to 1 is written correctly. So just make a correction here that y is equal to a times 1 minus cos t is there. So when we put y equal to 0, we get cos t is equal to 1. That is t is equal to 0 gives cos t is equal to 1 or t is equal to 2 pi. So hence one arc of the cycloid intercepts the x-axis at the points 0, 0 and other point is 2 pi a 0. That is from the above given curves we can find. So therefore the required volume is given by from that the limit of t is from 0 to 2 pi and for x the limit is from 0 to 2 pi a. So simply put that formula and use the values given to us. So we can find this thing. So this is the volume of a solid generated by revolving some given curves, and that is in the parametric form. So now we come to the volume of the solid generated by the region bounded by some curves, y equal to root x, y equal to 0, and x equal to 9, about the y-axis. So this is a different example from the previous ones. So that is from the last part which we were talking about. So here the reason is given here, that is you can look here for this curves y equal to root x, y equal to 0, and x equal to 9. So we are, when we revolve the vertical strip of the area between the curves x and that these two curves, so here what we are given, here we are given that the area when we revolve the vertical strip, that is here vertical strip, then we get some area about the between the two curves, that is x and x plus del x from the y-axis. So here we have to find the volume. So we generate a cylindrical shell, that means a shell type shell. I would explain it in rather some another way, that it is kind of a, we can say a disc type, or we can say as in the diagrams we have seen. So this kind of shell we are having, cylindrical shell of inner circumference 2 pi x, inner radius x, inner height y, and wall thickness del x. So these are the things which we will know after knowing little theory about the cylindrical shell method. So it's a very important method, but normally we use other methods for finding the volume of solid of revolution, but here we are given, so we have to do this example. So this is a little tough tough method we can say, because we have to do some computations here, like it is some visualization is much tougher than earlier ones. So here we have to know about the inner circumference of that shell and inner radius, inner height, and wall thickness, that is the thickness of the that shell as given in that diagram of that shell. So here we obtain the volume in this example as this 2 pi x y dx. So limit is from 0 to 9, that is from 0 to 9, and 2 pi x y dx. And so here a little mistake I think I have made, that is 2 pi should come here, 2 pi and then x root x, that is y is given as root x dx. So just add 2 pi in front of that second value of integral, and then simple calculation is to be done. So this method is a little bit trickier on the side. So why? Because we have to compute that shell, and we have to just see the inner radius, height, and then thickness. We have to talk about the thickness of the wall and inner radius, inner height. So use this method a very with some precise way, so that you should not make a mistake here. So just after that, one more example is here. Find the volume of the solid generated by revolving the region bounded by the curves y equal to 1 plus and root x and y equal to 1 plus x about the y-axis. He is asking about the y-axis. So the curves intersect at 0 and 1, that is x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. So the points of intersection are 0, 1 and 1, 2. So the region is plotted here. So these are the points of intersection of these two curves, that is y equal to 1 plus root x and y is equal to 1 plus x. So you can draw these two curves. So we have two different ways to evaluate the volume of this region bounded by these two curves, that is one with the help of vertical strip, or we can take with the help of a horizontal strip also. In the previous example also, we can take both the strips. So that depends upon you, that which way you are choosing. So here we are choosing with the vertical, that vertical strip method. So first one, that is, so we are when we revolve the vertical strip of the area between the lines at distances x and x plus delta x, that is the distances we are talking about. So from the y-axis, that is the distance from distance of the lines which we are given from the y-axis, we generate a cylindrical shell of the inner circumference, again 2 pi x, inner radius x, inner height y star, that is equals to 1 plus root x minus 1 plus x. That is, so that inner height we are given here, that is the difference of the both the two curves, that is the inner height which we are given. So that is root x minus x. In the previous example, you have seen the inner height is, that is what was that inner height is y, there it was y. But here, what is the inner height? Here it is the difference of both the curves. So what we obtain the volume as. So now just use that formula. Here the important thing in this method is that we have to compute the height of that shell. So that is the important part of this method, that we have to find the height, inner height of that shell, and then we can simply use that formula and evaluate the volume of solid. So here just use that formula and then put the values and you will get the volume of a solid. Now we are coming to the example which is of GEM, I think. So this exam question is from GEM exam. So what he's asking, the volume of the solid generated by revolving the region by the parabola x equal to 2y square plus 4 and the line x equal to 6 about the line x equal to 6. So here some options are given. So if we will draw this region x equal to 2y square plus 4, then we will obviously see that the region is symmetrical about the x-axis. So obviously this is given as parabola, then parabola is always symmetrical. So here it is here it is symmetrical about the x-axis. So the volume is obtained, this is the again, that is 2 times the volume of the solid obtained by revolving the region about the line, that is x equal to 6. This we have talked about such type of example previously. So just try to draw the diagram of this region and then see that when you will look into this type of region, you will see that the region is slightly up from the x-axis. That is, that's why we have subtracted 6 from x. So then you can simply use that formula and evaluate the volume. So here the parabola region is symmetrical about the axis. That's why we have used two before the volume. So that is, we have multiplied it, the volume, by 2. So now we come to the last section of our today's lecture, that is the surface area of a solid of revolution. That is how to evaluate the surface area of a solid of revolution. If some solid is given and we are revolving about some axis and or about some line, then how to evaluate the surface area of that solid of revolution. So now consider a curve y equal to fx, where curve is positive, and between two defined between two lines, that is x equal to a and x equal to b. So this curve is revolved about the x-axis to generate a surface S, as I can show you in the example, this diagram. So here you can see that this is the surface of revolution, that how to evaluate. So if we revolve the lines about the surface, about the x-axis, so what is the surface area? We have to take the area of that solid, area of the surface of that solid after revolving. So that is what we have to calculate. So here, so the curve is revolved about the x-axis to generate a surface S. Then after revolving, it will generate a surface S, and that for that surface we have to calculate its area. So for this type of curve, which is y equal to f of x, what is the formula for the surface area of the solid of revolution? That is, S is equal to integral from a to b 2 pi y under root 1 plus dy by dx whole square dx. That is ds, that is written in the form 2 pi y ds, where ds is given that under root 1 plus dy by dx whole square times dx. So this ds is the surface we have to calculate. That is the length, total length, which we can see in this diagram. That is the total length of that surface. So the area is length into we can say simply height, or if breadth is given, like that is the area for some rectangular region if we talk about. So here this is some ds is length. So here we have calculated the surface area for the curve y equal to fx, and similarly for the curve, if it is given x equal to some phi of y, so you can calculate the area for that also. That is means if the given region is revolved about the y-axis, then how to calculate the area, surface area of that solid of revolution? You can simply just formulate the dy by dx into dx by dy and replace dx by dy, and on the place of y use x. So this is the formula for the surface area of the solid of revolution. Now if the curve, earlier as we have talked about the parametric form, here also we are going to talk about parametric form. So if the curves are given in the form of parametric form, just like x is equal to phi of t and y equal to psi of t, where t belongs to t naught, closed interval t naught t1, so then we have what we have ds. Then we have defined the length as this, that is the under root dx by dt whole square plus dy by dt whole square times dt. So this is the length, that is ds. And just use this ds and use these formulas as earlier, this like 2 pi y. If you have given y, curve is y equal to f of x, and if a curve is given x equal to phi of y, then use 2 pi of x types this formula, second one, and use the formula for ds. This is the formula for ds. And if the curve is given in the polar form, that is r equal to f of theta, then again, where theta belongs to closed interval theta naught to theta 1, then we have the length, that is ds, is equal to under root r square plus dr by d theta whole square d theta. These lengths are earlier, as we have talked about them in the previous sections. So just use this value of ds and put the this value of ds in the previous formulas and compute the surface area of the solid of revolution. So just the difference here is between the ds, that how to compute the ds for simple curves, for the parametric form of the curves, and for the polar form of the curves. So now we come to the example part of this section. So first, the example for this section is that find the surface area of the solid generated by revolving the circle. This circle is given, which is centered at on the y-axis at B, that is 0B, centered on 0B, with radius A, where B is greater than or equal to A, about the x-axis. So we have to find the surface area of the solid, of this solid, by revolving the circle, this. So what we can do here, we can do that, we know that in the parametric form, what is x is, if we take x is equal to a cos t, then y, then what will we get? That we will get y as b plus a sin t, that we can compute from here. Actually, we can't compute this this simply with the help of the formula of the simple curve, but we have to change this question into parametric form, and then we have to evaluate the surface area. So simply what we have done the parametric change for x and y, and we are given a circle. So what is the limit of t? That is from 0 to 2 pi. So we obtain here ds, which is a. Simply just derivative of, by evaluating derivative of x with respect to t and derivative of y with respect to t. Then use the formula, that is 2 pi of, that is, if we are given y, 2 pi y, and that is ds. So you can use that simply. So that is, the surface area is given as 4 pi square AB square units. Now, the second example is the part of the lemniscate. R square is equal to A square cos 2 theta, where theta lies between 0 and pi by 4. And this lemniscate is revolved about the x-axis. So you can draw this curve, r square is equal to a square cos 2 theta. Then you will know about the lemniscate, what is lemniscate. So here I haven't drawn that actually. So just try to draw this curve, and then you will know about the region, what is the region he is talking about, and it is revolved about the x-axis. So now he is asking about the surface area of solid generated, that after revolution the solid is formed, and he is talking about the talking about to form the find the surface area of that solid. So here we have ds square is, that is ds square is equal to r square, that is for the polar form. So ds square is equal to r square plus dr by d theta whole square, and that we can simply compute as a4 by r2. Now so here, yes, so therefore s is equal to this is the formula for using the formula of surface area. So simply use this formula and put the values of that y, that is r sine theta, because in polar form we use x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sine theta. So simply use that value of y and ds, and then evaluate this surface area. So you will get the answer for that. So here we are going to the next question, which is again talking about the parametric form. So the line segment x is equal to sine square t and y is equal to cos square t is given, where t belongs to closed interval 0 to pi by 2. And this line segment is line segments, the region which is formed by revolving these about y axis. So we have to find the surface or area of that solid generated. So simply find the dx by dt and dy by dt. And simply you can use that also, that formula of parametric form. Also, you can evaluate dx by dy and use the first formula for that simple curve we were talking about. So if you will put that, so you will came to know about this. So that is 2 root 2 pi x dy, and simply you can use also. Now we have used the limit of t from 0 to pi by 2, and simply we have calculated the surface area. So actually in this type of questions for the surface area, these are not the tough ones, because everything you are given with, like limit you are given with, the curves you are given with, just you have to remember those formulas and use them by looking at the curves, that which formula fits into that question correctly, and just put those values and evaluate the answer. So this is a simple calculation based questions, but that these don't require much of the time, and they are not that much tough for the students actually. So now we are coming to the question which was in the JAM exam previously. So what he was asking, about the area of the surface generated by rotating the curve x equal to y cube, where y lies between 0 and 1, about the y axis. So we can use this simple formula for surface area of solid of revolution. So here in some questions, students, you will get to read that in this type of questions, here it is given that surface generated by rotating the curve. Sometimes you will find that surface generated by revolving the curve or something like this. So don't just get confused with terms. These are merely same terms. So for confusing, they use such time of such type of terminology. So simply just focus on the other parts of the question, what he's asking. So you can find the answer to your question. So simply here, use this formula. Here x is given as y cube, and you can find dx by dy, and then put the value of that you are given, that under root 1 plus 9 y power 4, and just use the change of variable method, that is 9 y power 4 equal to t, then we will get that t varies from 0 to 3 to 9 as y varies from 0 to 1. So just use these values and evaluate the integral. So simply, this is the question which was in JAM. So you can find from here that this was not a tough example. So these type of questions are asked in JAM. Actually, some examples we have discussed are more tough than these questions of JAM. So just try to focus on the question, that what he's asking, and just use your formulas, what you have. That he's asking about the parametric form, he's asking about whether he's asking about the polar form, or whether he's asking about the simple, like we use curves. So just try to focus on that question, on that part of the question, what he's asking, and try to focus on that part also, that what he's asking about, that he's asking about which axis he is asking about to revolve that solid. So these are the some parts to focus, and then simply use those formulas and you will get your answer very clearly. So this is a simple topic for the JAM, and every year you will definitely get some questions from this topic, that is from areas of boundary regions, area, that volume of solids, and from surface area of solids. So these are the some topics. So guys, this is the book which I was mentioning. This is a book by RK Jain and SRK Iyengar. So the book name is Advanced Engineering Mathematics. So this book is mainly focuses on calculus part of mathematics. That is like limits, continuity, derivatives, and this your areas type of problems and all those. So try to look into this book and you will find the content which I was discussing with you right now in this book. And there are a lot of questions to practice from this book, and simply you can find that if you practice these questions, you will get your confidence high, and definitely you will score better in these topics of IIT JEE exam. So thank you guys for listening me patiently. So thank you very much. So I will come to the conclusion. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Bond.
Yes, sir.
Now the time for discussion.
Yes, sir, sure. So,
students, you can ask your questions, you can your comments. Please switch on your audio and video, and you are now free to express your comments and ask your questions.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Good afternoon to both of you. Sir, I have one doubt. In earlier classes, we used to study that whenever we used to calculate you, area.
Can you please introduce yourself?
My name is Ravina and I'm from Delhi.
Yes.
So my doubt was in class 12th, we used to study to evaluate area of using integrals of functions. And
yes.
Then our teachers used to tell us that the area should be quantity. So we used to mod that area.
Yes.
But now we keep that area negative also. So can you explain, is that a vector quantity or a scalar quantity, or are we required to always mod that value?
Actually, for area kind of questions, we use, yeah, definitely you are right that we use mode for the area, because for any quantity, that region we are given, that we can't take that area to be negative. So this is, I think, a scalar quantity, because there is not any particular direction given here. So that is a scalar quantity area, but we have to take mod for that. Yeah, definitely.
But sir, we get negative values also sometimes.
Yeah, so in questions, they will definitely ask you for the mod, that after getting mod, so you have to present that value. Because actually, simply if you see that, if we are talking about some room and we have to find about the area of that room, like if it is rectangular, so anything which is like present outside us, that we are talking about its area, so we can't take about that talk that its area is negative. That means area is that how much surface it is having, that solid is having. So we can't talk about that negativity of the area. So simply just we have to take that mod. If we are getting that simply that if we are getting negative values, then also take that mod value.
But I have come across questions in which area is taken to be negative only, and volume is also sometimes zero.
Okay, so volume maybe, yes, volume we can talk about that volume. If we talk about simply just something we are taking that is completely filled, like solid, which is completely filled, or just for example, I will give you just like take some point and dot type of thing. And just if you would like to take its volume, so you will find a very minor type of volume. So that's okay, that we can consider that volume may be zero, but not always. But for area kind of questions, we always take like mod. So that is.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, please introduce yourself.
Sir, I'm Akash. I'm from Delhi, and I want to know that what is the geometrical interpretation of adding plus c in the indefinite integration?
So actually, in the first introduction of this session, I was talking about the antiderivatives. You have got to know that. So actually, for something like if we want to like for different in differential equations, we use sometimes like constants. So you have thought about that for differential derivative of something like in differential equations, we use c. So what is that? So for that we need a family of curves. So that's why we use a c, because actually that c is constant. When we do the derivative of that function, simply we will get that function derivative, and the derivative of constant is zero. So but that for integral, that integral is not specified. That for indefinite integrals, it is not specified that it may be something, some constant plus, because for integral, if we just want to evaluate that antiderivative, then that c will be automatically removed by the derivative. So just for that sake we use c. And in these type of like concepts, we talk about the family of curves. That's why we use c. I think that's
okay. Is there anyone else? See, feel free to ask questions and make comments. That will be very useful for us for arranging these type of sessions. All of you are welcome to ask questions and share your comments.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello, my name is Sri Lakshmi and I'm from Kerala. The class was excellent. Actually, this part has some formulas and also it was a bit confusing for me. So, yeah. And your class was made it more easier, and the examples that you have chosen was also good and it made me understand how to apply those formulas. So okay. Thank you, sir. It was very beneficial. Thank you for your effort. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sri Lakshmi.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Good afternoon. Sir, my name is Sanjita and I am from Kerala. Sir, today's class was really very excellent and the presentation was so good. It will be helpful for notifying all the formulas easily, and it will be very helpful for the examination. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Vinod, sir, for arranging this class. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you, Sanjita. Thank you. You can tell something about your IIT Gandhinagar Maths Department. Sugant.
Yes, sir. So actually, the department of IIT Gandhinagar Mathematics Department is very nice. Actually, the faculty is from all over India mainly, and also from the outside. That is, some of the faculty members are from, they have done their postgraduate PhD from the US institutes. So actually, it's very complete, full, very knowledgeable department, I would say. And they mainly focuses on pure mathematics. For applied, they focus, but not as much as on the pure. So the streams are there. There are wide streams like number theory, both for analytical and algebraic number theory, and algebraic geometry, and operator theory, for applied also, for algebra, and stochastic processes. There is a professor for stochastic analysis also, and number theory, I have told you. So a variety of faculty is there, And one center is also there, that is CLI. We used to call it a Creative Learning Initiative, that they used to present mathematics with geometry, that they make students to innovate like some pictures with the help of like cardboard, with the help of charts. They design the structure like these polyhedrons, dodecahedron, like these kind of structures. This is a different part from the department, and this is also doing a great work. So overall, I would say there is a lot of knowledge from one can get from the department, and also the faculty is very experienced, and they support the students very nicely. The exam conduction and the level of the exams which they take, and they are also helping the students with the different kind of sessions also there. And everything from the PhD students, they are also very nice. As a right now, there are not much student PhD students, only 15 up to 15, I think, students are there. And for the MSc students, there are 31 seats they take every year. So completely, I would say it is very nice departments among the newer IITs, apart from the older ones. So if one gets to join there, and it's very nice. And from the apart from the academic side, other things like hostels, they are completely new hostels, and a lot of things are given to you, like single rooms are also given to you in the second year, and internet is always for you. Like, there is no restriction on the internet, and there are two mess for all the hostels. And other things like sports, there is a very good coaching staff for the sports persons also. So overall, I would say it is a completely very nice institute, and it is on the outskirts of IIT, that is Gandhinagar city, and it is situated on the bank of river Sabarmati. So it is lush green and very beautiful campus. And if one goes there, and definitely he will enjoy his 2 years of journey. And from apart from that, definitely he will know more about mathematics also.